aperture is at the dextral coiling. Aperture is at the right hand side is called as dextral coiling. Okay, this here also it is at right hand side. Coiling is dextral. So opening starts from right hand side. If you go inside the shell, shell is coiled like this from inside. And if I put my finger in the same direction of rotation here on the paper, its movement is clockwise. Okay. Okay. See, this is how. This is also right hand sided aperture. It is also called a dextral coiling shell. I shall show you one interesting another shell. This is fossilized so that you cannot have clear aperture like this. This aperture or cavity is filled by some sediments here. Okay, if you can see here, this is the aperture margin. Can you see outer lip margin? Outer lip margin. This is inner lip margin. This cavity of aperture is filled by sediments. So you can see, if you hold the shell like this, the aperture falls at the left hand side of the observer. Left hand side of the observer. So this is left hand side aperture. Coiling is like this. Okay, the coil is like this. So if it is this type of coiling, if you go into the cavity, it is coiled from inside like this. And if I move my finger on the plain paper, it is anti-clockwise movement. Okay, so this is called a sinistral coiling or sinistral coil of the shell. So aperture falls at the left hand side. So the name of this species is Physa, and it is found in Maharashtra. This age is also Eocene to recent, nearly Eocene to recent. Okay, just out of curiosity, it is not for the syllabus. This is called a Cypria. It's not for the syllabus, but you can see the dentition on the lips. Outer lip is having dentition, inner lip is also having dentition. However, our shells of the syllabus, that is only three shells are there. Holuta, it is no dentition, it is a smooth margin of the aperture. So these are the three only shells for the syllabus. This is Holuta, this is Turritella, this is Conus. All three are having right hand sided aperture. So coiling is dextral. Okay, these two are Siphonostomatus. So I put it here together. Siphonostomatus forms a tube at the base or canal. It is also called as a siphonous canal, tube at the base. And this is not forming any tube, it is having continuous margin. So it is holostomatous aperture. These two are siphonostomatous apertures. Okay, long spire, short spire, very short spire, and this is short spire. This is short spire. Body hole, this is body hole. Suture line, here it is suture line, and in this shell, this is suture line. Outer lip, inner lip. Reflected out, inner lip not reflected, this is inner lip. Slit like aperture, very narrow and slit like aperture, circular aperture. Okay, ornamentation in the form of dentition or knobs like this. Smooth shell, no ornamentation. Ornamentation is in the form of ridge. Can you see elevated part here? Ridge like ornamentation. That's it.